Hi everyone, so this workout is going to be really quick. I'm going to give you some tips and a workout for beginner Pilates. I've modified a lot of the exercises to make them just a little easier. Pilates for beginners. So first things first, make sure you breathe. Take a few deep breaths to start. If you are stressed, this will actually help to calm you down. Use this stretch to create as much length through the spine. This will warm up the body and mobilize the spine. The second tip, posture. It is so important to sit up straight. Imagine you have an invisible string pulling you up. Exhale twice to rotate. Inhale to return to center. You'd be surprised, but a lot of people chew gum in class. Don't do it. Inhale to float the leg up. And exhale to arc the thigh through space. Then repeat to the second side. Up, up, down, down. Take one leg up 90-90. Followed by the other, and then float one leg down and then the other. Inhale to lift one leg up, exhale to lift the second leg to 90-90. Really concentrate on contouring the waist by drawing the tummy in with each exhale. Inhale to float one leg down, exhale, the second leg floats down. Toe taps. Keep the abdominals soft. Don't let them bulge up. We want to create a flat abdominal structure and not a bulgy out one. Imagine you're lying on sand. Not one grain of sand will move under your back as you arc the thigh through space. Exhale as you arc the thigh through space. Inhale to return. Another tip, this actually really works. Lift in and up through pelvic floor. This will help to fire the transversus abdominis, which is the deepest layer of abdominals. Just imagine stopping the flow midstream when going to the toilet. Create one long line from the knees to the shoulders. Redefine your hamstrings and glutes. Exhale to articulate the spine. Inhale, reach the arms up over the head. Soften the breastbone away from the chin and articulate through the spine to return the hips down to the ground. Create more length through the spine as you reach the arms up over the head. Tuck the pelvis under. If your neck feels tense, remember to start your curl up with a little head nod. This will help to fire the deep neck flexors and give better neck and shoulder placement. Remember to look at your pelvis to curl up to get the best neck placement. Find your neutral pelvis. The hip bones and pubic bone will be on the same plane and there will be a little bit of space under the back. exhale to curl up, reaching to the opposite leg. Inhale to lengthen back down. Keep the pelvis stable. Single leg stretch. Hug one knee into the chest. Exhale to reach the leg away. Intensify the single leg stretch by curling the head and shoulders up off the floor. This will help work the upper abdominals, balancing out the abdominal structure. Next step, take your hands behind your head. Use a generous rotation with flexion. Don't force it. Don't force your body before it is ready. Funnel the ribs into the waist. Let your Pilates instructor know if something doesn't feel right. Don't be shy to let him or her know. Scissors. Curl the head and shoulders up off the mat, holding behind the legs. Exhale to scissor one leg away. Inhale to change. Exhale as the legs split away from each other. Double leg lowers. Float both legs up to 90-90. Place the hands under the pelvis. Exhale to arc the thighs away from the body. Inhale to return. Single leg circle. Reach one leg long up to the sky. Inhale as the leg crosses the center line and exhale to circle down and around. Reverse the direction. Repeat to the second side. Practice your exercises in front of a mirror. Your technique will improve out of sight. Keep the shoulders down and keep the neck lengthening long. Up and down. Inhale to lift the leg, exhale to control it down. Leg circles. Repeat to the second side. Forward and back. Imagine the energy moving down the shins to the toes when pointing. And imagine the energy moving up the calf when flexing the foot. Up and down. Get the most out of your leg exercises by stretching your knees out fully. The cat stretch. Come onto all fours. As you exhale, articulate from the tail to your head into flexion. Inhale and reach the sit bones back, articulating through the spine into extension. Reaches up. Open your heart. Hovers. Inhale to prepare. Exhale to hover the knees up off the floor. Inhale to hold, exhale to hold. Inhale and float the knees back down. Float the navel gently to the spine. Lift in and up through pelvic floor. Swan preps. Lie on your tummy with your hands under the shoulders. Exhale and extend with segmental control through the spine. Inhale to return. Keep it small. Keep the shoulders stable. Keep the shoulders down away from your ears. The rising swan. Exhale to lengthen the elbows while extending the spine. Feel support through the lower belly and activate the glutes to stabilize the pelvis and the femur bones. The hip bones are lifted up off the floor. Inhale to return back down, lengthening through the spine with a long arc through space. Add a twist, looking over each shoulder with an exhale. Child's pose. Wait and rock in this shape until you feel a release through your lower back and hips. I love Pilates as it has given me confidence and strength in my body. I hope you really enjoy the whole experience of doing a Pilates workout with me. You did great. So I'm going to need your help to choose the next video. What should I do? Another Pilates for beginners, Pilates challenge, or Pilates for knee pain? Music by Paradise Band Boys. If you have any requests, let me know, because your comment can inspire the next video. And don't forget to subscribe.